Thank you for joining us on this very special episode of the Mamas in Progress podcast. We are your host, Cecily Rose.
And I'm Shelby Renee.
And today we are very excited about this special episode because we are talking to one of my good friends who's also a blogger, Rosie Nguyen. And the title of this special episode is called From Corporate to Creative.
Yes, I'm super excited because not only does Rosie have this amazing story and journey going from corporate to creative, but you two recently teamed up on something that you got to tell everybody about.
Yes, yes. Before we get into all that, I want to introduce Rosie and let everyone know how fabulous we is before we spilled the beans and what we did. That was exciting. She is a successful, talented family blogger who is also a vibrant, fun, colorful content creator here in Los Angeles. She has thousands of followers, and I know she's probably going to cringe when I say that, but she does. She has thousands of followers on social media and a very successful blog that I personally love. It's called The Hustling Mom. She covers everything from what she finds at an Asian market food store to crafting with cardboard, which is phenomenal and creative. Like, I had no idea that you could make Ruth Bader Ginsburg's face or Breonna Taylor's silhouette in a cardboard, but it's just fascinating. Mm-hmm. So she covers a wide array of topics, but they're all done with a lot of creative thought. And what Shelby was kind of like hinting to is we were also on Supermarket Suite
on ABC.
Yes, on ABC. Woo-hoo. So today we're going to talk about those two things because, funny enough, the blogging kind of led to Supermarket Suites. It's a long story, but we're going to get there.
I love that. I mean, how many people can say they've been on a game show? I know I can't. So I'm sure people are really excited just to hear about that. Any funny stories from behind the scenes? It looks like so much fun. Like, we've posted some of the promos and you all, hello, what, Leslie, help me out. The host name.
Leslie Jones.
Thank you. Sorry, y'all, mommy brain. But she posted you guys. She reposted you. You all got a lot of love. So, I mean, I just think it's so cool.
Yes, it was a lot of fun. We tried to represent for all the mommies out there. The name of our team was called Team Cold Coffee. And we had to come up with that at the last minute. But that was just a shout out and paying homage to all the moms who get up in the morning, who make that fresh, hot cup of coffee. And they're trying to drink it. But here come the kids.
Yeah. Right. I got some cold coffee right here, y'all. That's a great team.
Cold coffee.
So yes, let's get into it, Shelby. I know you have the first question. We'll start from the beginning.
Yes. Okay. Before we get into all the amazingness of Supermarket Sweeps, I just want to hear about a little bit about the Hustling Mama. What was the inspiration behind it? How did it come to be?
Yeah. Oh, first off, thank you so much for that really awesome introduction. I feel like if I had a PR person, that's what they would have said. So that's the beginning of the Hustling Mama was not really intentional. My husband, we moved from Texas to California. And so my husband went to grad school. I thought I was going to go back to work, but daycare fell through. So I was continuing the stay-at-home mom life. And I was like, I need a creative outlet. But also I needed a place to really store memories of the kids because my husband was missing like critical years. It was my daughter was turning 2 to 4 and my son was turning 4 to 6. And those are huge milestones in between. So the blog was kind of created to capture these memories for him. We also let the grandparents so they could also go to one place without me repeating a million times what we did that week. And then it kind of just grew into something else. So that is kind of the core inspiration. And I need a creative outlet. So.
No, I love everything that you said. I was reading a study that before, this is pre-pandemic times, but 43% of moms take time off after they have kids at different stages for different reasons. So it was interesting to hear your personal story related to that. So was it, in terms of just leaving your career, how was that for you? Was it scary or was it something that because you all relocated, it just kind of naturally happened?
Yes, ironically, when I started stay at home mom, I was actually leaving California back to Texas because we're actually from Texas.
Okay.
And so we're like, oh, there's a big house there we can buy. You know, our parents are there so we can, you know, have the grandkids with the parents or the grandparents. And that's how it started. And honestly, I just never thought I would be a stay-at-home mom. I was always in like that brainwashed corporate mode. But what turned out to be the hardest decision was actually the best decision that I made. So really, really surprised about that. I'll tell you more later. It was a huge like mental struggle for me for a while.
Oh, no, you're not gonna tell us later. Tell us now.
Please let me know.
That's what moms struggle with a lot of times. Yeah. Is like, they want to leave that corporate life, or they feel so torn and they don't know how to make the steps. Yeah, I admire you.
We like spend so much time, you know, just climbing up the corporate ladder, trying to make it to the next promotion. And then you're like, oh, wait, you're in this position where you're like, how often does this happen that I get to spend time with the kids and actually be there? Because I actually missed the first couple of years of my first child, Austin. Mm-hmm. He was in daycare. And at the time I was working for, I was doing advertising. Very time consuming. I actually went from one really demanding career to another. I went from business consulting, which I thought already had crazy hours.
Yes.
And then I was attracted by the world of advertising, and it was for like Apple. So it was like a really sexy opportunity. And I did that, and the hours were even worse. I mean, granted, I was learning a lot and it was really fun, but like in terms of like a mom, you know, work-life balance, it was like, it was not happening. And so I was also just burnt out by California. I was burnt out by my job. I loved it, but also I had a baby and had another one coming as well. Mm-hmm. So we were kind of like, ding, ding, ding. Our grandparents are begging for, our parents are wanting to be close to our kids. Texas, you can get a lot more, bang for your buck in terms of home. And so we just kind of went over, but I noticed there was like two big struggles that I dealt with, right? One was the physical struggle, right? I was like exhausted because I was raising kids, but I also, no one tells you how crazy blogging world is. I mean, just even social media, when I started the Hustling Mama, it was just kind of like, there was no algorithm in my mindset back then. I just posted when I felt like it. I did fun projects with the kids and it was great. And then I don't know how over time people would find me and they would follow. I was kind of creeped out because I'm old school. I'm like old school Facebook mentality. I'm like, whoa, friend request. Who are you, creeper? But now in this world of Instagram, it's like, oh my gosh, thank you for following me, And so it just, and I think naturally also I create and curate content for a living. So I kind of enjoyed like, wow, people are actually finding value in the work that I was doing. For example, when we left Texas to California, my kids were like, my husband went to school full time. So they're like, wait, where's Baba? And I'm like, oh, he's in school. And then they're like, well, where are the grandparents? You're like, we left them in Texas. And I was like, oh crap, did we like just mess up our kids' lives, right? We just changed everything. I just kind of thought, oh, you love the beach, you love California. And it just became this thing where I was like, okay, I need to entertain my kids. I am the only consistent factor in their lives, right? Yeah. And so I came up with things like the Tada cooking show. My kids already love doing fake cooking shows. So I was like, well, let me just record you, I love video anyways. And it just became like this thing where instead of them asking me repeatedly every day, where's Baba? It was like, what are we making this week? And I'm like, well, let's go to the grocery store. And, and so that took care of that. And that, that was the beginning of parents like, oh, I love that idea. And I was like, oh, well, if it can help me and help you, that's great. And that's that just kind of turned into like more things. My kids were drawing the same trucks and princesses. So I was like, we're in downtown LA. There are so many amazing art murals. So let's just go out there, plop in front, take out some paper. And as you're drawing your version or, your impression or whatever of this mural, I'm going to Google and just educate you a couple things about this artist because I don't even know myself. And then we started sharing that. And that became a really cool thing to teach kids with art. And then mentally, so the physical struggle is just trying to juggle everything. As as a blogger, you're like your own, social media person. You're handling all the admin work. You're doing all the creative work. You're like managing the scheduling, and you got to post every day. So, the algorithm will help you out and, share your work with everyone. Like being a solopreneur these days is insane. And it's funny because when I chose the name, The Hustling Mama, it was purely because, oh my gosh, all the domains were taken. I chose like the longest name, The Hustling Mama. And now I'm just like, it's true. I feel like I'm hustling, right guys?
Well, yes, yeah, definitely. And hustling well, might we add.
Yeah. And what I was going to say is like, I love your site because you are so creative, but it doesn't feel like lofty. Like some mommy bloggers you see, you're like, now I am not going to be out here doing that because you are just bragging right now. But you make it so fun in a way. It's like, I want to try that. Like, mm-hmm. it's aspirational, but it's also welcoming and inviting. And that's why I chose to follow you even before I knew you. I was just like, oh, that's cool. Now, mind you, I never did any of the stuff that you were doing because I was just, but I loved looking at it and it was inspiring to me just to see it. So yes. I think that was like a key factor just for me. But I know you said that there was like that mental shift that you had to take in your mind.
Yes. The mental shift is, sorry, I'm going back and forth because I'm trying to think back. It was actually a lot. The mental shift for me was like, you know, I never really had plans to step off the grid because I spent so much time climbing that corporate ladder. And then at the time it presented itself. I'm like, you know, it makes sense. I'll just do it for 2 years. Let me just, you know, let's just do it for 2 years. And then that ended up being like more than 2 years. Right. And then I never really, like, all this stuff just kind of fell on. It's just like this opportunity with the supermarket suite. Things just happen. And that's actually something I really love about the blogging world, is because you never know what to expect. And so, and my husband's always like, well, what's your plan? I'm like, well, other than, you know, doing what I love, which is creating content and creating this awesome community where I get to make really cool friends like you guys, like, I just never expected it, you know? But the mental struggle is just kind of like, you know, the moment you start the stay-at-home mom life, you're like, okay, it's like this ticking clock, you know, you're like, okay, well, that, and you want sleep, but you're like, okay, the kids are getting older. They're going to be around daycare age. And, you know, when do I go back? How do I go back? Am I able to go back? There's all these questions that continually go through your mind. And so even though people think or view me as successful every single day, I am just like, kind of, there's a part of me that I still get those LinkedIn emails, like, you know, or Indeed emails, like, oh, here's a new job posting this week. Cause I'm always keeping track. Like, maybe there's a better opportunity. Mm. If there's a better opportunity that pays very well, that's enough for me to pull me up from what I'm doing now, then I'll consider it. But, you know, it took me a while to get to this point. Right. But I'm always struggling. Like, am I, you know, I've been off the grid for like 3-4 years. Will someone look at that and be like, so what, you know, I hate that question. It's always like, oh, so what were you doing this whole time? You know, it's like, raising humans, learning these multitasking skills, right? So, and I think a lot of, I feel like a lot of stay-at-home parents can relate to that because it's true, you know, are my skills like so outdated? You got all these, you know, young new kids coming in, doing their thing, working up the ladder. And I'm just kind of like here changing diapers.
Okay, know, that's not true, Rosie. Rosie, first of all, you have not checked out her site, you have monetized your site, yes. And you're being able to get sponsored posts and you're making money. And I don't know, you know, what that range is, but you have made it to be a source of income.
I'm doing cardboard crafts. It can't be that much.
Well, no, but you've been able to monetize this endeavor.
Well, you've established a brand and that is a skill in itself, especially with your advertising background and your corporate background. So, and a business consulting background. So you're building a whole brand, which is huge to do on your own. So there's definitely so much value to that.
But I do want to point out, this did not happen overnight. It took me like 3 years to get to this place. And again, this is where the mental struggles, right? For the longest time, I was like, well, when am I going to go back to work? Will they take me back? Like in the working world in general. And it was around the 2.5, maybe third year that finally is just kind of that feeling, that nagging feeling just kind of, it didn't go away completely, but it just felt like it lifted off my shoulders, you know? And now I'm like, wait, what I'm doing can help pay the bills, you know, slowly but surely, you go from electric bill to rent, right? Things like that. But then you start to make this choice. You're like, okay, well, I could go back to work and make, you know, like a regular steady paycheck,
right?
Or I can actually build what I have going now and then, and also have these fun adventures and actually be happy and be with the kids, you know, while I can.
Right.
And I think it's important to point that out because I wasn't always like that in the beginning. I wasn't making money. I was just doing it because I enjoyed it. You know, and I was making some friends here and there. It was a very, very slow beginning whenever you start anything, right?
Yes.
And it's really hard because a lot of people will drop off at that point. They're like, oh, I'm not going anywhere. Right. I'm not making any money. And people are making, like, you can't compare yourself. And I'm glad you pointed out earlier that you follow my page because I don't give you that feeling where you're like, what am I doing with my life? I actually started unfollowing those people. They were like poison in my feed.
Yes.
Will Smith did this post and I favored it. I listened from time to time. And it was something about, like, you know, have people who, fuel your flames or something like that, right? And
yes.
It doesn't gas your fire. And I was just like, that makes so much sense, you know? And on top of that, just I think just in that period, I was like, why am I following people who just makes me feel like a crummy mom? Like, I already feel like a crummy mom sometimes. When is the last time I made lunch on time? I'm crawling on the floor because I missed the Zoom window lunchtime, which is like 30 minutes, you know? And I'm like, here, turn off your camera, eat your food. You
know? Yes.
I don't need to feel bad about my parents. No one does, right? Mm-hmm. And so I started removing those people and it made such a difference. But also just wanted to point out, this did not happen overnight. This took like 2-3 years. So, you know, you guys started your podcast and you're growing. And I love your mom rants. You know, you were talking about Zoom the other day and I was like, uh-huh, yes.
Thank you for that. And I'm so glad. That's such a great point that you're making, because we do hear a lot of moms, you know, think that it just happens overnight. Like you build this big following and, you know, you get all the sponsors and it just happens like that. And I'm so glad that you're sharing that, because I think a lot of people need to hear that. Not saying that you shouldn't start it or do it, but you need to understand that it takes time and it takes consistency, right? To be able to get to that point. So that's really super, super important. Yeah. Now I see that you guys are twinning and I feel a little left out because purple's my favorite color, but it's okay because it's for a good cause. So I want to hear, first of all, I want to hear the story of how you guys met. And then I want to hear more about this supermarket sweeps experience.
Okay. I'm going to tell my story. Yes. Supermarket sweeps. I'll tell my story and Rosie, you can tell yours. We were at a blogger event, a mommy blogger event celebrating a mom who is launching, who launched a magazine specifically for moms.
Here Los Angeles Magazine, right?
Yes. Yes. Say it again, because I think I cut you off.
I think it's like LA Mommy Magazine.
Okay. Yes. I recognize Rosie's face because I'm really good with faces. I was like, I know her. Like, I know her. But I just couldn't figure out in my mind, like, where do I know her? And that's the power of social media, right? Yes. Like, you feel like you know people in these streets. You know what I'm saying?
True.
So, for whatever reason, we were like at a cocktail table and I was like, I'll follow you, you know, because it finally
You're missing the best part.
Okay.
So you saw me, you recognize me. I am just like, this is my first, like events with people, because you know in blogging you're lonely, you're at home all the time, right?
Yeah,
you're hiding in the bathroom, the pantry, wherever. And I was just like, why did I come to this thing? I'm really nervous. I wanted to support my friend, and I was like, oh, there's so many people, and I had all these old high school feelings come up, like, oh, people pressure. And I was like, okay, just talk to one person, one step at a time. And I saw Cecily, and you had a baby bum, you were glowing, you had this crazy like beautiful neck piece. And I was like, I'm going to talk to her. She sounds like she has her act together. And I went over there and I was like, hi, my name is Rosie or whatever, you know? And you're like, oh, I follow you. And my head like blew up. Like, what? Get out of here. And the one person I like talked to, and I'm in this like mindset, and you just put me at ease. You're like, oh yeah, I follow you. And you're like checking, you're like, yeah, I do. I'm like, that's, and it's funny because in the blogging world, that's like the second question, you know? You're like, oh, what's your handle? You know? Mm-hmm. And I was just, that made me feel, of course, nice. But I was like, thank you, that's great. And I forgot that I was even there. I just wanted to connect with you, because that was just like that like almost never that like never happens, right?
Yes.
So that's that's when you caught me, and I was just like, what? And then we just started talking. You can go on, sorry.
Yes. So then we just started talking, and you know, talking blogger biz stuff, and we actually are a part of the LA Mommy Blogger Tribe together. And so we would do shout out to the LA Mommy Blogger Tribe, and we would just do events together. Like we would because I love doing family friendly events. You do a lot of family friendly content. Yeah. So we would just end up at blogger events things together and see each other, you know, around town and stuff like that. And fast forward to one of the producers slid into our DM. You know, the DMs on IG be popping sometimes.
Honey, they're popping all the time now.
Yes. So they were like, hey, do you want to do a game show? And originally it was going to be with me and my husband, but he's not for the shenanigans. You know what I'm saying? Like, he ain't for the shenanigans.
Same here.
Yes.
Dan's like working, like real work. He's like,
yes, real work. Like, real work is happening. And I'm over here in the Hollywood shenanigan world. Yes. So the producer was just like, well, you know, I really, you know, like you, but do you know anybody else? Like, is there anyone else that you can partner with? And I was like, who can I partner with that's like game, that's excitable, yeah, you know, that's yeah, like hustling. I was like, hustling, yeah, hustling, hustling, hustling mama. You know what I mean? Yes. So I'm like, yo, I slid up in her DM and I was like, hey, do you want to do a game show together? Do you want to be partners? Wow. And literally the same day that I was being interviewed by the producers, she was actually being interviewed by the producers too. They were vetting her as well. And wow, she was like, you know, I don't really know if my husband, well, I'll let you tell that part. So
no,
as that's going on, what's going on your end?
Dan, I can make you your favorite dinner all week. All you got to do is dot, dot, dot. He's always like, what are you up to? So my husband, he works full time. I mean, we do too, right?
Right.
And he was just like, how's that going to work with my schedule? This is me typing, by the way. How's that supposed to work my schedule? Or is this getting paid? I'm like, well, not real. No, no. But it's a fun adventure. I think my audience would love it. And I guess part of me didn't think we would actually make it very far, but so I was trying to convince him. And then literally an hour before my interview with the casting person, Cecily DMs me and she's like, hey, what about this? You know, and you know, would you be interested? And I was like, are you kidding me? This must be a sign, because I am literally about to talk to these people in an hour. My husband doesn't want to do it. Let's just do it. Yes. And the whole time I also thought, it's not going to happen. Chances. And, you know, I just didn't think it was really going to happen, but I'm game for an opportunity, especially since it was almost like during the pandemic, I was just like on repeat, mom mode, mm-hmm, teacher mode, janitor mode, everything, you know? And I just was like, something different, something for myself. And I didn't really think about the full complications it could be. I just thought, mm-hmm, I just needed something different. And that's so true because it was right
in the middle of that pandemic and when everything was really, really on lockdown in California. And it was like, we were truly in a bubble. And this was the only like bright light that we had was just this opportunity. And
well,
I don't know.
They also said, they were also saying, oh, it's not right now. It's like for later. Mm-hmm. So I wasn't thinking like, oh, you know, I just kind of thought, okay, well, maybe like when the pandemic's over, you know, Yopo, you only pandemic once, right?
Let's hope.
Oh my gosh, I don't know why. But it was always pushed like, oh yeah, for later. So I was like, okay, yeah, that sounds great. Let's start the process then, you know?
Yeah, so we went through the process and then they were like, hey, we want you to be on the game show. You got to get your COVID test. And I don't know if I shared this with you, but I was thinking about pulling out because I was like, I'm being selfish by going to a game show during the middle of the pandemic and I could get expose my family. And this is just not right. Like Cecily, so I was really struggling with that because there were family members on the East Coast that were having issues with with COVID. Mm-hmm. And it was just a lot. It was overwhelming, but thank God that we, you know, continued forward because it was such a fun experience. But
that's so funny you said that. Because why? I was thinking, I had those thoughts too. Like, you know, my family, immediate family's right here. So I was thinking, mm-hmm, you know, that's not really responsible. I'm over here being really paranoid about everything. Yeah. But then part of me is like that bad devil version of you, like, do it, just do it. For later, you know.
And this is why we're friends.
I was like, but Cecily is down. So I think I also was kind of like, well, if she's interested, and again, I didn't think we would actually make it that far. Mm-hmm. So I was like, let's just entertain the idea, right? So I was like, well, Cecily has no problem with it. I'm just going to go along.
That's so funny.
I had no idea you were thinking about pulling out. Because if you said that, I would have been like, yeah, you're right. I'm going to pull out too.
I'm glad that we didn't pull out. And that just shows you like, you know, you building your brand, me over there with Holly Montrose and just, I guess, being average moms in Los Angeles and teaming up as moms and representing moms at the grocery store. Cause you know, moms in the grocery store, we got that. That's one thing.
Hold that down. Okay. How were you all at the grocery store? Like when the pandemic first started, I mean, I look so scary. People would go away from me because
I had the mask, the glasses, the gloves, the hat.
They would see me coming and literally leave the aisle. I'm like, great. That's exactly what I wanted.
Oh my God. That's so funny.
How are you, Rosie? Were you like really at the beginning, just really like overly paranoid and just with all the gear, your own PPE?
We were overly paranoid. My husband's like, oh, I knew. My husband has been keeping track of the news since like January overseas. Okay. So he was telling me, he's like, it's coming. I'm like, a pandemic, whatever. Whoa. That's in Asia, whatever. Mm-hmm. Next thing you know, for Valentine's Day, he gifted me like my full-on mask with the filters. So I was like, and I made a joke about it. like, really? Not as a joke, bad joke, but I was like, well, this is my Valentine's Day gift, so I'm posing all saucy with this mask.
Right.
And then shortly after the pandemic started, I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm so glad you, like, you know, ordered all these things. We shipped masks back to our families back at home.
That's
so
nice.
We were prepared, except for toilet paper. We didn't
prepare. I was gonna ask. I was like, did you have some TP?
You know, we had, like, we always have, like, because I like to order things in bulk. So we had like one or two, but the news just made you feel like it's gonna go by fast. I considered getting a bidet, one of those toilet, like, thing that shoots out water. I'm like, oh my gosh, what's gonna happen in the world?
Yes, a lot of people started getting bidets. I mean, I will say that was the one time that my hoarding, because I also buy in bulk, I was like, it paid off. Like, my husband, he used to complain. Now he's like, order as much TP and paper towels as you want. So we are stocked up again for the second wave, if it happens.
Yeah, I heard about that second wave.
Yes. So tell us, I mean, I know there's some things you can't say, but what was it like shooting? I know, like you said, it was different because you were in a bubble. And can I just sidebar real quick and just say, I love to hear this story because it's moms supporting moms and women supporting women. And, you know, you all immediately, even from that moment that you first met, because I feel like sometimes, and you all can share more insight about this, but in the blogger world or even just in the mommy world, there can be so much competition and, let's be honest, some mean girl stuff. Okay.
Unfollow. Right.
I just love to hear this story where it's like you all celebrate each other, support one another.
Yes, you're absolutely right. And here's the thing. I think it's a choice because mm-hmm. like, even though me and Rosie are in the same space, you know, we have actually been up for the same gigs before, and like really big gigs. And I remember, okay, Rosie, you mind if I talk about it? I won't say what the brand was, but both of us were up for like a really, really big brand and opportunity. And Rosie actually got it. And she deserved it because, like, I feel like for that particular brand, it was like spot on. If I were the person, I would have been like, she totally got it. But mm-hmm. that was something for me. Like, I had to swallow that and say, okay, Cecily, how are you going to move forward? I know Rosie's like, this is getting heavy. Like, this is just me. But like, how are you? Rosie's like, oh Lord. But I was like, you know, how are you going to move forward in a space where, you know, there's competition? Like, there's competition in the workforce. And then also maybe if you have like a side hustle or blogging or whatever. But I was like, no, you know, this is a time where you need to embrace and surround yourself with people who are great at what they do. And I've always admired Rosie for what she did. And that's why as soon as they were like, who else could you think of? I was like, Rosie, bam. That was like the one thing. I was like, bam, this is it. You know what I mean? So, but it
is. You're my PR person. You're hired.
No, but it is there. Like, it is. I think because so many people see the advantages of being on social media or blogging, there is that competition there. I mean, honestly, I follow a lot of people that might be like that. I just mute them. They don't even show up in my feed. They don't even, I mean.
Just unfollow. Self-care.
I can't unfollow because then it's like, oh, she unfollowed me. But if I mute them, then I just never see their pictures in my feed. That's anyway.
Can people see if you unfollow them? Look, I'm clearly, I don't know.
Well, they can look and see if you follow them or not.
Oh, okay.
Right. But like, you don't get like a notification. There are third-party apps that used to do that. But because of all these like, changes in Instagram, some of these third-party apps don't even work anymore. But some people say, oh no, I see. But like at some point, it's also just not healthy for you as a blogger to keep track of those numbers, because as you know, the algorithm, like, numbers are, they're all over the place, you know?
Right, right.
And people follow and follow for whatever reason. And it's just more things to mess with your psyche. So I just don't even like it, you know? And I'm sorry, it made you feel that way, Cecily.
No, don't be feel that way at all. Oh my gosh, no, don't remember.
I do remember you said something like after it went live and you were like, oh, I was up for that too. And I remember thinking, oh, because I thought they just like picked the person and was like, okay. And I didn't think, I don't know. I didn't think like there are other, I mean, yes, I guess they're interviewing other people, but I just assumed like they already made their choice mm-hmm. or they were like, no, they actually, no, it was like an interview process, but I didn't feel like, I guess it is pretty tense like that. I guess I just always think like, oh, it's not going to go anywhere. But also they don't really tell you the names of the projects you're working on. So you can be like, oh, it's for something. We can't tell you the name yet. Oh, and I'm just like, okay, this is like another DM request, whatever. I'm like, okay, I guess this is it. Oh, you're asking for more information. Okay, I'll, you know. And so I didn't think it was like big until like they told me, and they were like, okay, you're gonna have your own, you know, food stylist. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is like something legit. Like, you don't know. And that's the beauty again of blogging. Is like,
yes,
I never, when I was doing like kid videos, I never thought it would lead to this. And I'm not saying this is the best or whatever, but it's just like really unexpected cool opportunities. And I think that's one of the main, that is probably one of the main reason also that I'm still doing this blogging thing versus going back to work, because I feel like that window of me to like, to at my peak, to go back to work, my peak really meaning my lowest peak, because I'm so exhausted from the kids, right? But right. When I told myself those first couple of years, I'm like, I have to go back to work. I have to get back to work and not fall behind. And mm-hmm. like, I don't know. It's a lot.
Well, I'm so glad that you've let that pressure go, because
it's it makes a huge game changer. Like I tell people who are also starting out, like, try not to worry about the numbers, but once you get to that point and you just, you know, it is what it is. I use that meme all the time. It is what it is. It is. And I feel like you can actually enjoy Instagram again. Like, you know, I've been at 11K followers for over a year, and I'm okay, because as people drop off, there are more quality people who jump on and they stay around for me, you know, and I focus more on them. If you notice in my comments, I'm like almost 100% always engaging back with them, commenting, because I want to have a real conversation. I don't want to be like, cool, thanks. Like, I want to actually, if I can't, throw in a joke, because I love jokes, but I want to build that community, because who knows, Instagram could be gone tomorrow. And what am I left with? I'm terrible at collecting emails from my email list, right? So I just try to build relationships in the community. Mm-hmm. And that so far has saved my sanity. And I feel like my work is happier because of that, because I'm not like stressing. I share when I want to share. I don't post first thing in the morning every day anymore. I wish I could, but I'm, you know, being a one person, one mama show in this world is freaking hard. I got kids. Don't forget it.
Right.
This world is, mommy is hard. So. If anyone worries about that, just send me a DM. I will just woosaw you. Like, you don't need all this additional stress, and your work and everything will blossom with a healthier mindset. It's self-care, social media self-care, I feel like. So,
and speaking of your kids, they also blog as well. Like, they have their cooking show and like their shows too, which you want to give your handle?
Honey, they don't blog.
Tell the truth. That's,
so I started The Hustling Kids. I'm The Hustling Mama, spelled T-H-E-H-U-S-T-L-I-N-G-M-A-M-A, not Hustling Mom, not Hustling Mommy, like all that exists. I'm Hustling Mama. But my kids are just called The Hustling Kids. And I only created that because I was noticing they were taking over my feed. And you get lost because as a mommy blogger, what are you actually sharing? You know, of course I'm sharing family, but I just realized that I wasn't really in any of the pictures. And it's funny because, you know, I bet you some moms will be like, wait, am I in my own feed or is my kids taking over? And I mean, not that I'm all like, oh, it's about me, but I feel like to connect more, you know, you need to have that, right? And it's like, honestly, people don't really care about your kids, like, unless they get to know you as a person. And then it's like talking to your friends, you know?
Yes.
And there's so many moms who are, I mean, there are some people who are very successful in that. But for me to be able to connect, they got to know me to care about my kids, or else it's just kind of weird, right? No,
I think that's a great point, because it's good to have like from the mama perspective and then from the kid perspective. Because I know like my kids are 3 and 5 and they love watching, you know, content produced by kids on whether it's Instagram or YouTube, TikTok, you name it. So I think it's great that you have that for them.
Oh, you know, now that you say that, I lied.
What?
My kids are not slowly. I think I've been, because they see me blog all the time, they are becoming little bloggers. I like.
Yeah, I think so.
I think they're like, oh, you know, because they started taking over Tata Cooking, and then I couldn't keep up with the editing. So we come back to it from time to time. But no, they are becoming their own little people, their own little personalities. And so they're like, I catch my daughter like pretending to vlog on her phone. So she's slowly, they're in that world. But I think as far as them out in social media, I control that. Right. So I don't want them posting things, but I love that they're creating and they want to like create stuff, and they're expressing themselves in that way. But as far as like their handle, that's me. I'm the one putting those, you know, captions in a kid's tone of voice sometimes. Yeah.
Right. But it's creating that skill set, like you said, like just them seeing you in action. And then now they're starting to get into it. And who knows? And
these are great life skills too, by the way.
They're great life skills. So in a couple of years, I'm pretty sure they'll be handling all of that. And then they'll just be sending it to you for approval. like, here's the vlog I did, mom. Is this good? Okay, put it up, you know?
I'm now the hustling grandma. You kids run along. I better get that domain. Yes,
you should get it now. Ooh. Get it now.
The hustling grandma.
I love that. Hey, we got to look ahead, plan ahead. What is that? You know, future planning for the future. Yes, absolutely. It's been great. I mean, I'm so excited. And for everybody who's listening or watching, make sure that you check out Supermarket Sweeps on ABC. And we'll make sure to post on at Mamas in Progress, as well as Holly Momstress. I'm sure the Hustling Mom will also post just like tune in information and how you can watch it again if you missed the first time. So just please make sure that you all show love to Cecily and Rosie, and was it Team Cold Coffee?
Yes.
Slide up into the DMs and post comments on the ABC sweepstakes, or what's the IG for the show?
I think it's Supermarket Sweep.
Is it Supermarket Sweeps ABC? I think it's Supermarket Sweeps ABC. We'll check that and we'll make sure to post the links too.
Okay.
Yes, you're right. Supermarket Sweep ABC.
Okay.
Yeah. And again, slide into our DMs. We're just regular people. Don't feel like, oh, they're never going to respond. I always respond and people are like, oh my gosh, you responded. I'm like, I'm just a regular person. Like, just, you know, if you have questions about getting on the show, I mean, Cecily, I'm sure you'll be pushing out content. I will be doing a blog and a blog post about how we got, like, tips on how to get on any game show, you know, our experience. We barely touched upon it about the audition interview process, but it was a huge ordeal.
It was long.
It was like, and it wasn't just one time. It was like, can we do 3 different interviews? Can we can we run through some game show scenarios? So we were studying in between. We were trying to remember logos. We were trying to, like, we actually studied. I told Cecily the day before, I was like, it was literally like 10:30 p.m. before the taping, which we had to show up at 6 in the morning or something.
Yes.
And I was like, here are some links. Let's study the floor plan of this a possible floor plan that they have. Because, you know, every grocery store has a different floor plan. They're a little different, but they're also kind of the same. So I was like, just FYI, because, you know, we need to know, right?
Yeah.
We should learn. It's like school again. Here are some logos, the top logos right now. Let's remember and study them. And I think one of the biggest, I feel like one of the biggest difference between us, Cecily, was like, you were like, you just, you know, I was like, I just want to have a good time. I just want to get out of this pandemic funk, you know, mindset. And you were like, oh, it's on now. Yeah. Remember? I kept saying,
I was like, where the money at? But where's the money at, though?
I was like, Cecily, we're just here to have fun. My main concern was I didn't want to look like a fool and answer, you know, or miss a really easy answer.
No, yes. I was the one who looked like the fool. I covered that basis. That I took care of that.
No, I was like, you know, and then I was like, just, you know, Cecily wants to win. Just, you know, just don't mess that up.
No, it's a lot of pressure.
It was a lot of pressure, but the thing is, I mean, I wanted to win money or win something, of course, but I wanted us to have fun because like Rosie said, it was in the middle of the pandemic. This was the only thing that was hot and happy happening in our lives at the time. So, and my husband just kept saying like, go have fun. So,
that's awesome.
Yeah. And I feel like we did have fun and the other contestants were great. We all had fun. I mean, and you can't not have fun running around with Leslie, who's like top energy, and you're in a grocery store. Like just the whole premise is fun. But Rosie didn't make a fool of herself. Trust me. If you all see some of the promos, then you know that I clearly
check that box.
Check that box.
I had a friend who was like, is that he's like, does she ever get off the floor?
Jesus.
You know, we had a good time. Great.
And this is why you should tune in, because I will trust me when I tell you it's a great episode. Yes, you should definitely just tune in. It's definitely shenanigans. And I'm so happy that we had that opportunity, Rosie.
Yeah.
And here is to more adventures on social media. You are an amazing blogger. I definitely look up to you.
Likewise.
And I encourage everyone to go follow the Hustling Mama. And
right now.
Yes, right now. We're going to leave all that in the notes. And what's just if you could tell us your handles and what social media platforms you are on.
No problem. So across Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, I think I attempted TikTok, I don't remember. And of course my website, it's The Hustling Mama, that's T-H-E-H-U-S-T lingmama.com for the website. I push out fun family content. I also try to keep it real from time to time, just to kind of give you that, you know, fact check in life, right? We're just, you know, what you see in social media is glamorized, right? Like, no one has a perfectly clean home all the time, right? Let's be real. You know, I just try to keep it real, and I try to keep it light. And I honestly want to spread joy and positive vibes, because why not? Yes. We need it, especially now.
Yes. Why not? Okay, first of all, your background, if anyone who's watching this on YouTube, it's got a rainbow, it's got a plant and a sunshine with sunglasses.
It's making me happy.
Yes, it is.
It all makes me happy.
You got a disco ball.
I've been wanting this for a long time.
So cute. So,
yes, thank you so much for doing this with us. I'm so excited for everyone to watch us on Supermarket Sweeps and to continue hopefully following us on our platform. So thank you, Rosie.
Yes, thank you, Rosie.
Thank you for having me. So nice to be on here.
Yeah, it's such an honor to have you. Thank you so much. We really appreciate it.
Bye, guys.
Bye. We'll see you soon and come back.
Oh, have me back. I'll be here.
Okay.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
She's so
best.
Fun.
She's awesome.
Yes, she is. I love her. I heart her. But yeah, that's the power of social media, like making new friends virtually, and then it turns into like real life. Like, who knew?
Real life, once in a lifetime experiences. And plus now it's like a friend, like a real friend for life. Like, it's just, it's wonderful.
Yes, yes. Like, I had no idea that at that time when I met her while I was preggers at some event, that we would end up on a game show, like rooting and praying and begging for each other to like answer the right questions so we could possibly win money. Like, you just never know.
You never know where life's going to take you. And also, it just speaks to like how I love how she shared that story about how she was nervous. She was getting those high school vibes of like, okay, let me just find one friend. And it says so much that like you were beaming and glowing and welcoming, like you had that energy. And that's a good tip in itself. It's like, we have to remember, you know, we're all going through our own internal battles. So it's like, how can we just like let our guard down, be open and inviting and welcoming, just so someone feels comfortable with even saying hi. Like, you just never know, you know, what something that small, like what that could lead to, and and just how important that is to be, you know. And as moms, I mean, I've certainly dealt with it. I'm just gonna keep it 100. I've been in environments where I'm like, oh my God, I mean, it makes high school look like freaking kindergarten with the mean girls.
Yeah.
So I really, really love that part of you guys' story.
Yeah, and to give it full context, there at that time, there were a lot of the mommy bloggers in the room, and there were mommy bloggers in that room who I would consider, you know, quote unquote, mean girls. And it was taking a toll on my psyche just from another's perspective. And I just remember being pregnant and just being like, you know what, Cecily, just, okay, don't focus on the mean girls. New opportunities, new thoughts. And so I wish I could brag and say that I'm always like, hey girl, but I was struggling with my own internal issues on that same day. Mm-hmm. So I literally had to push myself through trying to ignore some other stuff that was going on and make new friends. And you know, here we are. So yes, you're absolutely right.
Yes. What I also loved about her story is just how she made that leap from corporate to creative. That's something that I'm super fascinated with, because like how she said, like, I miss my kids. I have not, you know, she said she missed her oldest kid or the youngest kid. Like, she missed one of them, like they're growing up, or they're, you know, those different developmental milestones when they're really young. Let me tell you, I have not been there for anything. I'm just going to be honest. I have to be honest about that, because my career is so demanding. Like, it just is. And maybe, you know, other people are able to find a better balance. So I'm always just intrigued and inspired by moms like Rosie who have made that leap, you know. And it's something that I think about, like, well, I think for me, I decided that that's something I want to do when my kids are older.
Yeah.
So I'm like, in my mind, and we'll see, y'all hold me accountable, but I feel like I'm making the sacrifices now, so that I'm hoping the plan is that by this, I have a date in my head. Mm-hmm. And once that date comes, then I'll be able to make that transition. But I just really encourage all the moms out there who are struggling with it to know that there, you can pursue your passion. You can, you know, decide to go a different path if you want to.
Yeah. And that's a hard decision to make. Like, am I going to keep making this bread, or am I going to go over here and just devote myself to my children? Because those children will suck you dry after 3 days at home with them. You're like, oh, I think I made the wrong decision.
Oh, honey,
like,
I was
got to have a plan.
Yes. Cause after that maternity leave, I was like, yep, I'm good. I'm ready to get back on email. Y'all loop me in. I'll be at the meeting. I am good, honey.
Yeah. It's
when we weren't working from home, I'll be the first to admit that I'm that mom that's like, Sunday, I'm like, okay, it's Sunday, I can't wait, let's go to bed, everybody go to bed, I'm ready to go to work. So that's why I said you have to know, I guess, if it's for you. But I mean, clearly she is a solopreneur and she has a big business that she's building, you know, but it's something that she's passionate about. So she had to go through that evolution and that journey, which I find really intriguing.
Yes. So just know that if you are thinking about making that leap from corporate to creative, and I really like the statistic that you said at the top of the show about so many moms or just people who are working who are, you know, making that leap, but just know there might be a game show at the end of that rainbow. Yes. You never know.
And that's amazing. I mean, that's huge. And I mean, and also, what I wanted to talk about very briefly is that now, because of the pandemic, a lot of moms are having to make that choice. It's kind of being forced on them, unfortunately, of having to leave their job. So some moms are having to take leave, you know, family leave, and some moms are just having to quit altogether because of the, you know, whether it's, you know, just distance learning or just other circumstances. So I hope that this will be encouraging and inspiring to some moms who maybe aren't happy that they were kind of forced out, you know, like they didn't get to make the choice, but you know, maybe there's a blessing in it that now you can start something that you're super passionate about and it could grow and blossom like the hustling mama.
Exactly. And it's yours. I mean, here's the thing. You create something that's yours, because let's be clear, Rosie has skills that is going to get her into another job. That might be her own mental, just thinking about that. Right. And if you were in a corporate job, you have that skill set. So I feel like that type of skill set will always be there. Mm-hmm. You can just put that energy into another, you know, put it into something else. Right. So just being able to maybe pass that legacy down to her children, teaching them a skill set, or starting your own business on the side. I never feel like that's just a lost opportunity. Mm-hmm. And it's so important when you decide to make that transition, I think, to surround yourself with other moms who are going through it, because sometimes your husbands and your partners don't, your male partners might not fully understand how difficult it is to leave corporate and then focus your energy on your children, on your household, and to try to manifest a passion. Like, come on now, that is straight superwoman status. It's not easy. Right. So you need to find other moms who are going through that, who can mentor you, pull you through, who can say, this is how I'm doing it, giving you tips and facts, or just give you a hug and say, it's going to be okay. Because like Rosie said, it's a process. You know, she had to work herself through that, being consistent. So that's definitely for sure.
Yeah.
Get you a good village on that one.
Yes. I love that. Well, I think we kind of combined tips and and our two cents with that. And I mean, I love this episode. I hope everyone is getting a lot out of it.
Yes, absolutely. So let's jump into Mama Wins and Mama Rants.
Sure.
All right.
I'm like, where to go? I don't even know. Okay. How about you start? Cause I got to think for a second.
Okay. You got to think for a second. Let's see. Should I do a Mama Win or a Mama Rant? Well, we did it. Our last rant was about how we hate Zooming. So this week, what should I talk about?
And that's still going. Well, I have a quick win that I can share.
Okay.
And this is kind of, okay. So I don't know if you're like this or other moms are like this, but I feel like since I become a mom, I don't get to spend as much time with my friends who aren't moms or are single. And so one thing that has really helped me just kind of reconnect and I think become a little hipper. I've never been a part of a book club, but I was invited to join a book club, and it's a dynamic group of young women, and most of them are creatives and super successful. Like, I'm like, how did my old behind slide into this amazing book club? But it's been great for me because it gives me a chance to really fellowship and have a meeting of the minds with women who are at different life stages. And you know, we so quickly can get into just mommy mode and mommy talk that we're not really having conversations about stuff outside of motherhood. And yes, it's a big part of our lives, but I was just telling my husband, I was like, I had a life before you, boo.
Well,
so, that part.
Facts.
Facts. And even like Rosie said, these kids are gonna grow up, God willing, and honey, they're gonna be like, peace, deuces, figure it out.
They might not even say thank you. Right. Might not.
Right. So I'm really just enjoying having a dialogue with women who, and it's not about being a mom. Most, I think I'm the only married person as well.
Oh.
So it's just it's very refreshing to move myself out of kind of like this bubble of motherhood and wifedom or whatever you want to call it that I live in every day. So I just encourage everyone, like whatever that is for you, find some sort of outlet that allows you just fellowship with people outside of being labeled a mom and a wife.
Ooh, that's a good one. Now, I like that. I don't know if that's a mom win. That's kind of like a mom win and a mom rant tied into one, because that definitely speaks to me. I definitely feel like most of my social circles are like in the mommy space. And so it would definitely be good to have like an outside circle that has nothing to do with that. Okay, can I ask what book you guys are reading?
Oh, so our book, and we actually have book club tonight. It's called Luster. And I cannot remember the
that's good enough for me. I like the title already.
It's about a young Black woman who ends up having an affair with a married man. Hussy, I don't want to give it away, but can I tell you, I was clutching my pearls, ma'am, just two pages in. So
two pages in. Well, listen, okay, I might just have to read
that
book.
I'm gonna sip my cold coffee on that note.
Okay. Well, now listen, that might be a book that some mamas do need to read so they can keep up. Okay. Don't get left behind in these streets.
Girl, I was like, is it really like this out there in the world? You know, that's what I'm saying. Like, I never would have thought to read that on my own.
You out here making macaroni and cheese for these kids, and these these other folks are out here doing luster. Okay.
Bam.
Oh, that is hilarious.
It's so that's what we're reading. Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Okay. Well, that needs to be my mama rant, because I have definitely been in mama mode. I don't have that many mommy friends. I don't have that many friends who are not moms. Mm-hmm. There's a couple, but it is true that when you become a mom, it's kind of all consuming, and you're young, hip, skinny, single friends who don't have kids or who are married and still don't have kids, they're out here, you know,
dipping and doing.
Exactly, dipping and doing. And so I don't get a chance to hang out with them as much as I would like to. So I don't even listen. I can count my single friends or my friends that don't have kids on one hand. Okay. Yeah. Just one hand. So that would definitely be something that I would need to look into for sure. So,
another one in the bag,
as always. You can follow us on Instagram at Mamas in Progress. We are also on Facebook at Mamas in Progress, or you can always slide up in our DMs. We love a good slide in the DM, or you can email us at mamasinprogress@gmail.com. You can see this taping on Black Oak TV, which is on YouTube. And you can also download us on iHeartRadio, Spotify, and via Apple. Child, we're trying to be everywhere. So thank you so much for listening. If you listen all the way to this, thank you so much for rocking with us. We don't take it for granted. We appreciate that you are a part of this Moms in Progress community, and we value you. So yeah, hit us up.
Love it. Mama's out.
Mama's out.